Once again, down the walls, Kessel. Letang slides it over to Malkin. Chris Letang, Phil Kessel, hold, shoot, score! Kessel the shot, Hornquist was right in front, power play goal, the Penguins with the icebreaker.
Yeah, Patrick Hornquist right in front of the net was able to get his stick on that puck, change the direction, a downward direction on Domingue. The Penguins on their second power play, they're going to capitalize. Rotation and the shot, and there's the redirection. Domingue looked like he was going to look it into his glove hand. And there's the stick, and there's the deflection. Domingue is grasping for air as Patrick Hornquist has put the Penguins up by one.
Hornquist at the hash mark, takes the pass. Hornquist looking, short side shot, stopped by Domingue, on the scramble, back to Malkin. Tees up the shot, never got through. Backhand pass, Kessel's got it, fires, he scores! Phil Kessel from the slot, another power play goal. The Penguins up 2-0.
Well, Patrick Hornquist was punching that puck with his glove when Domingue was trying to stop it. I was wondering if it was a hand pass. Here's Hornquist, here's the shot. Then he hits it, maybe with a cross check. I initially thought that was a hand pass, and then the snapshot right there by Kessel, off a body and in over the glove hand. But I know that the coaching staff of Tampa are arguing, thinking that Patrick Hornquist had hand passed that puck. Look at the flex in the stick. He didn't even shoot it that hard, that stick, with about an 80 flex off a body and in over Domingue.
That penalty doesn't show up yet on the board. Here's Stamkos across, driven, and it's deflected away as Kucherov. One time that. Here's Point, shooting, scores! Braden Point off the post and in with 2.7, takes care of one of those penalties, and the Lightning get a desperately needed goal back before the intermission.
Yeah, they have been sharp at creating opportunities. Kucherov had one again. They haven't been in the offensive zone a lot. There's the Kucherov shot, but the retrieval. You have to have that, and they have the advantage of two men. How about that for a shot? Braden Point, that is perfection. He's able, because he's a righty on the left wing side, his stick is in the middle of the ice. He gets a way better angle than if he were left-handed.
In that first period, Johnson out of Kucherov down low. Jack Johnson down on a knee. They work it around and score! Point off the Stamkos pass. He scored again. And this game is tied at two.
Oh, great patience. Absolutely great patience by all of them. Kucherov just waiting for Stamkos to drift into the middle and get everybody's attention. And Stamkos is so good with the threat because everybody knows around the league what a great shot he has. Look at that. Look at that fake. Everybody's frozen. The three guys that Pittsburgh have are thinking, uh-oh, it's coming from 91. Nope, right onto the tape. You can see where Matt Murray, the goaltender, is. He's out on the edge of the paint expecting that one-timer from Stamkos.
Point now in the slot. Kucherov swerves in front. Point shoots.
Wow.
Scores! Braden Point, a hat trick and power play goals. Point, his first hat trick in the NHL, and it's scored in the span of a minute and 31 seconds in play.
For Patrick Hornquist, 2 points in the first period. Same thing with Phil Kessel. Backed in on both Pittsburgh goals. Malkin on the forecheck right in front. Scramble, score! Hornquist, he's got another one. The Penguins' persistence pays off, and we're tied at three.
Well, this one, I think, is on Domingue. He let this puck come out from behind the goal line. Penguins get a good forecheck. They dump in on Hornquist. They go back. Miscommunication. Look at this. Malkin. That puck comes right out underneath between the pad and the stick. Right here of Domingue, who misses it. And Hornquist shuffles it in after Domingue tries to poke check it. He misses it there. He misses it there. And we're tied at three.
Off the backhand of his stick. Got it back. Out to Sergachev. Johnson waiting in the circle. They go back to Gord. He scores! From distance, Yanni Gord fires it home. It's 4-3 Lightning.
We don't usually see Yanni Gord scoring from that far out. Usually he's about 8 inches off the edge of the blue paint. But what a terrific one-time shot that was. from right in the top of the circle. He got all of that one. Good body movement by Gord on the pass from Sergachev, and just blows it right by Murray on the far side. You can hear the clank right off the post. Sergachev's supposed to bring the puck into the middle, get the defenders to shift just a little bit, create a little bit of a seam for Gord to shoot. And